light shafts coming down through the ceiling and would stand around my bed and start turning into a human-like looking form. Very ugly, very lizard looking.
This being rushed at me across the bed. She had a tool in her hand and she was performing some mysterious procedure on me.
I thought for a while they were ghosts, but these beings materialized into a physical form, so they might be from another dimension.
What the Western world doesn't know too much about, but what Islam brought the deep ocean of realities, were the jinn and the unseen creations of God. For those who operate with their heart, they're very much seen. In the name of God, most compassionate and most merciful, we are an energy being. And there are many dimensions, many levels of creation, and many realities of which we don't understand. And one of those understandings in the realm of light are the unseen, which are not unseen for those whom operate with their heart, they're very much seen. And what the Western world doesn't know too much about, but what Islam brought a deep ocean of realities, were the jinn and the unseen creations of God. And they are created from the oceans of energy, like electricity. For every one of us that God has created, He's created 10 of their creation. So they're very numerous in number and they explain a lot of what can't be understood in the West. When they talk about aliens and they talk about encounters and they talk about abductions, for us those are jinn. Those are the jinn in your home that are abducting you every day because they're in the home, they're in the home environment. They are manifestation, they come through energy. When you turn on the TV, the energy that comes through them is them. When you listen to music, the energy that's coming through the sound is them. When you have a high-speed internet, because they're an electrical being, they are facilitating their movement through all of these components and all this that we sort of help to bring into existence by their inspirations. We said that the timeline of mankind, of horse and buggy, didn't really move until the advent of electricity. That's when they really wanted to put their world into this human world. And as a result, the height of shot up. We went all the way to the moon within 60, 70 years. So it means their whole movement and understanding is through that electricity. So when we study energy, when we study sound, we understand the sounds that are vibrating. Why do they want humanity to listen to such bad songs now with horrible lyrics and horrible words? Because to resonate at a low frequency so they can become possessed. So if we don't understand energy and frequencies, that's what's happening. So spiritual masters all knew that when you resonate at a high frequency, you actually destroy those lower beings because your resonance is so high, your zikr, your chantings, your mantras, your breathing practices are so strong. When the lower sort of demonic and evilness come towards your being to occupy you and to sort of live with the human being, the higher frequency actually hits them out. And that vibration shatters it, and God says in Qur'an that, say to the truth when the truth comes, falsehood is perishing. And falsehood by its nature is always perishing. I mean that which is false, it can't stay within the face of the truth. And the truth is a light, is a purified light, a holy light, a sanctified soul with its spiritual practices. So that becomes the spiritual warrior. the one whom builds their light and builds their frequency, builds their chanting, why are they warriors against all these demonic forces? So then look at what is happening to society and to children now. The games, the videos, all of these are a bombardment to lower the frequency. When you lower the frequency of humanity, they become possessed because the negative energies that are coming into them and overtaking them. And it doesn't take much for an energy being to overtake a physical person that has no ability to understand or to have any spiritual practices. For us, we're like a television for them. They merely just touch your being and they can cast images into the head, into the heart. So imagine them coming into your physicality, then yes, it would be a horrific thing. And this is what possession and sickness. So much of the culture doesn't understand this, and they used to. You know, the concept of genius, when we use the word genius, was from genies. You had an abundant of Jinni surrounding so that you had abundant flow of knowledges, because their knowledges are far superior to the human knowledge, unless it's a knowledge given by the people of the book in which they study the book, and God gives them more powerful knowledge than the jinn knowledge. Sufism has a deep understanding of all of these, like a science for them. Most sicknesses and disease is caused by that realm that you don't understand. When that energy realm comes and one of them is nefarious and they just merely begin to touch, they can send all sorts of sicknesses and negative vibrations within the vascular system of the body. So we're a very frail creation. When you don't have spiritual protection to wear, we have spiritual protections to wear. When we don't have spiritual practices and we don't meditate, we don't pray, we don't do our chanting, then you're just like a clay pot, and these creatures come into the pot, they make people sick, they make all sorts of difficulties upon them. So yes, they're everywhere and in everything. Most sicknesses are caused by their proximity, most decay and bacteria is caused by their proximity. And the difficulties that are facing humanity has been taught by the Prophet of Islam, that when pandemics come, it's the attack of the shayateen of the jinn. That when they come too much into the human arena and want to become too close to humans, their nature, these nefarious ones, their nature is very dirty. They release all of their waste through their skin, their smell, their sicknesses and bacteria. As they approach near people, they become sick and sickened by them. And their interest is to enter into the human being and attack the vascular system and the respiratory system. It's the bronchial tree and the respiratory system of humanity, because it represents a great reality within the divine. And the negative force is fighting to enter into human beings and to overtake the respiratory system, the bronchial tree, and to stop them from having a purified breath and from having purified experience, because the power of the breath. That when the breath is good, the zikr, the chanting and all of the energy of the breath, what happens with that breath? It's a divine breath. That we've been given this grace by God as a secret for our breath. When that breath comes into the breath, it actually nourishes the heart. And then when it pumps with the zikr onto the heart and goes out to the lungs and the blood becomes purified and dresses all the 11 organs, you can see then the importance of the breath. And that's why all spiritual paths are based on the breath and the reality of the breath and how to sort of master the breath. All that been lost. And now we see all these respiratory diseases in the last days and all the sicknesses that are coming. And it's for that very nature, and that's why the devils, they don't want spiritual training, they don't want spiritual advice, so they don't put shaykhs and spiritual masters on any satellite that they control, and that's the difficulty. So that this realm of the jinn, they want to occupy the earth and all of its humanity, and they want them to be enslaved by that reality. But there are soldiers of light, and the kingdom of God is coming, and it's just a matter of people to prepare. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
A Timeless Reality with Shaykh Nurjan Marahmadi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com. With your generous support, we have helped many of the needy around the world. You can make a difference right now by helping us support those who need it the most. Give now at nurmuhammad.com/donate.
The importance is if we lead a physical life and we think only in physical terms and only emphasize on the brain, this life is just one-dimensional. It's just its physicality. Mysticism and spirituality, which was the norm and now became the estranged and the less practiced, is mysticism was that you had to keep a balance in life. You had to practice your physical practices, discipline the bad characteristics, and then what we would have is tafakkur. And in every language has a different word for the realization of the soul. There's a light within the heart and our life's duty is to nourish that light and to bring out its reality. And God has given us all like a temporary existence on this earth, like a candle. And if we don't take care of that light, this world by its nature is to blow out that light. And our reality of why we've been sent on this to earth for a physical experience, that we are a spiritual being sent for a physical experience. And the training of Sufism and mysticism is to nourish that light, to protect that light with the good deeds, the spiritual practices of meditation and prayer and selflessness. So those whom are only physical, the world teaches them selfishness, to be selfish, what they want to take. But God and the divine energy, by whatever name people want to understand the reality of a higher power, much more powerful than ours, wants us to be selfless. And by selfless deeds and selfless acts, you can bring out the power of your soul. So which that is not no longer just a little candle flickering in the wind, because the wind wants to take the light out. This world by its nature wants to take the light of the heart out. By spiritual practices and joining spiritual masters, because they guide you. It's like having a sponsor, that if you are in an ocean of difficulty, it's very difficult to lift yourself out of your own difficulty, much of which you can't really even see. The concept of self-help, we don't believe, because it's the self that's causing you the problem. What we call the ego, the nafs, the bad desire, here in the West we call it the self, as a sort of a like an oxymoron. That's the creature that's bothering you. That's the creature that teams up with every evilness and the self-glorification, the self-gratification, all of that has to be brought down. And so that spiritual training and the accompanying of a spiritual master is to bring out these realities of light and these realities of the bad character, identifying it, bringing it down, and then how to bring out the good character with good deeds, good practices, meditations. Once you train in meditations, then what makes the shaykhs and the students to be different is they train in the realm of the light. It means they entered into the realm of light and they train in it, they understand it. And as a result, there are two senses for everyone. You have hearing that your audience hears with their ears, but you have an inner hearing. Every sense God has given us, it's two versions. You have an inner ear to hear, but do you hear? So, yeah, I hear. No, you're just using the physical ear, but you really didn't hear what God wants us to hear. So the inner hearing is when you sit and meditate and to try to connect with your consciousness. The belief is that God didn't give us this light to destroy it. Like, here you go, here's your inheritance and let's see if you can blow it into the world. But He gave us only a small portion of that light that's in the body. The greater light is always in His Divinely Presence. So it's like a spiritual connection. That's why the Prophet taught that who knows himself, he'll know his Lord. He'll even find his Lord if he finds himself. So the journey for God is not outside, it's inside. And that was the Lord of the Ring, the opening series of Lord of the Ring. They were walking on the mountain which represents the heart. That our journey is not finding God on the outside and in buildings and in structures, but God is within us. And to go inside, and that's what the Prophet of Islam taught, that the inner fight is the greatest fight. The jihad means fight and struggle. The struggle against oneself is the most difficult struggle because there's no bounty to collect, there's no money, there's no prosperity in it. It's just the attacking of oneself, coming against the bad characteristics. But the demonic and negative force is so strong trying to come against the self. That's why it requires to accompany a master and a teacher, which was the role of Gandalf. Gandalf started off grey because he was also on a path towards reality, and at which point he became Gandalf the White when he went through the bridge and fought his own demon, and he came out from his death as Gandalf the White. So God is marketing. God is marketing to all audiences. It's not just in a mosque that you'll find God, but He's marketing to all His creation because He loves them. And through modern media, and there are some spiritual movies, they have some bad scenes that are maybe not appropriate. But the whole of it, and can be understood, that these are movies of guidance. And that when you take a guide, all the badness that you'll fight and all the demons that you'll fight. And kingdom based on goodness, righteous acts, cleanliness, piety and modesty and everything that we do. So that's the preparation. God's kingdom is very clean. Whatever you can think of the most purest reality is a bond above that, beyond our even understanding. So in the Lord's Prayer, when we say the kingdom of God is coming, that means that we have to live a life as if God's kingdom is on earth. We pray, we fast, we do all of these practices. One, to make sure that God is happy with us. And the side benefit is that you'll be protected from all of these sicknesses and difficulties and all of these negative energies that also are trying to make the kingdom on earth. Illa sharaf al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa alayhi wa ashabi kiram wa la mashayikhina fi tariqatina shbandiyyata al-aliyya wa sayra wa saddatina wa siddiqina al-Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Shaykh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue.
Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, NurMuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Shaykh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide. From feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. NurMuhammad.com/donate.